Yeah, my name is Osman. I've been living with this group for 1 year and something. And yeah, we've been through struggle, we survived and many, many places. And yeah, and for the last 2 days it was not easy. And yeah, when we were, the house we had, it was, and the contract was finished and we are on the street. And we hope we got a place to stay at the OT 301 for one night. And then we got a place at the church in East for one night. And yeah, today with the help of the people here, they call us and they say they have a place for us to stay. And yeah, we are very thankful to them.
So what happened today? Like, you came with the buses? Could you explain more about?
Yeah, when we were just sitting somewhere and we were confused, we didn't have any place to go. And yeah, and the people came and they say, yeah, you guys need a place to stay and we have a place to stay for you. We didn't know. We came with the buses and they told us to come in and yeah.
And who are those people and what happened here? Like, what they did?
I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay. And what is your situation? What you would like to achieve by, like, what?
Yeah, we needed a place to stay because we are human beings and we don't have a place to stay, and it's going to get cold, and yeah, we want a place to stay to continue with our demonstration and to fight for our rights.
What is your demonstration for?
Yeah, our demonstration is for the refugees who are being denied here to stay in the Netherlands, and their case is still going on, and they cannot go back to their country, and here they cannot stay, and they don't have any place to be. So yeah, we want to change the asylum policy in this country.
And how would you like to change it? What you would like to improve?
Yeah, we want to an asylum policy to become more human and to have many rights, and because this is human beings' life we are talking about. And I believe in anywhere in this world, any human being is not supposed to sleep in the street. It's not supposed to don't have any kind of food, nothing. We need to change the policy to become and to give the people their basic human rights.
But why they don't have rights? Because normally the homeless have rights. And why you don't have?
Yeah, that is a good question, because I see homeless people. They have lives. They have everything. And yeah, because I think because we come from Africa and we are refugees, and yeah, it is their way of saying we don't want you in this country. That's why we deny your rights, and it's not fair. That's why we want to change that, to show them that we, even if we are refugees in this country, we have the right to stay here, and we have the right to be in the society, we have the right to go to school, we have the right to do all those things human beings do.
And what you do to fight for your rights? Like, is this part of your campaign, or?
Yeah, and our campaign is, and for 1 year and something now we've been campaigning. We started in Ostrop, we sleep in tent and camps, and then we got this big church, we stay there now, and then we got a flat and we stay there. And yeah, we program and we go on the street, we demonstrate. We go to the parliaments, we demonstrate, we go to the city hall, we demonstrate. And yeah, and this is how we know how to do. So in order for us to do that, we need to have a shelter, you know, a place to sleep so that we can continue doing our demonstration.
Would you like to add something to the people who would watch this movie?
Yeah, I just
how the people could help you.
Yeah, I just want to tell the people that we are not criminals, we are not and bad people. We are just human beings who come from countries of war, and we are guests in your country, and we want you to support us, to bring us food, to bring us everything that we need. We don't have anything at this moment. We just want you guys to come and talk to us and help us and hear our stories, and it helps. You know, when some people and citizens, they come, they talk to us, they ask us how we are doing, they hear our stories. And that is more important what we want. We want our stories to matter. We want to share our stories with the world. And just don't think that these people are bad people, but the situation we are living is not good. So we want you guys, the citizens, to come in and talk to us and get to know us. And as long as they come and talk to us and get to know us, our stories will change their life.
So what is your story?
Yeah, my story is, and I came and from Somalia. And I've been in this country for almost 10 years, and I don't have any family in Somalia. My mother and my father were killed when I was young. I was tortured with the rebels, and I was in prison because I refused to work with them. And then I escaped. I escaped for my life, you know, and I came here to get help. I thought maybe this they have more human rights and they can help me with my situation. But yeah, when I came here, I was innocent. I didn't know anything. And yet, the problem that I ran for from my country and the problem that I faced here is too different. Because there I was running for my life, but when I came here, they put me on the street I was on the street. It was cold. I didn't, every place I go, nobody helped me, so that is my story. And I'm now in a country that doesn't want me here, and I cannot go back to my country, Somalia, because it's not safe. So, and I lost my half of my life, 10 years in this country, to survive from street to street, from friend to friend, from all over, you know. So that's why 1 year ago, it happened automatically that we had many people that were sharing the same stories like me. We all came together and we started something. We protested for our life, for our rights, and for our humanity, and it reached us here. So, as long as I don't have any family, but what I know now, I have these people. This group is my family. They know me better. I know them better. And this is very important.
That's it?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Will you introduce yourself?